So we started, amen, looking at this topic on last week, amen. We started, amen, talking about the fact that there is a treasure on the inside of us. And I shared with you on last week, one of the biggest issues and dilemmas that we face, amen, is that many of us in the body of Christ, many of us the people of God, we don't recognize our value. And I just want to encourage you on today, amen, and let you know that no matter what you're going through, no matter what your situation may be, amen, what's going on in your life right now, you have to know no matter what it looks like, no matter what you look like, no matter what you are dealing with or what's trying to deal with or control you, there is a treasure in you. Somebody say, there is a treasure in me. So we understand that the definition of the word treasure, is a valuable object. It's something that is very precious. It's used to describe precious metals or gems, amen. A treasure is also something, amen, Webster says, is carefully kept, something that's valued and something that is loved, amen. And so a lot of times we don't recognize who we are in God. We don't recognize our value in God or how valuable we are to God. And I shared with you on last week, it's one of the things that I love about God is that God doesn't see as man sees, amen. The 1 Samuel, the 16th chapter, the 7th verse lets us know, amen, that God doesn't look on the outward appearance as man does, but that God looks on the heart, amen. And one of the things that I share with you that I love about God is the fact that God is not distracted by the package, amen. He's not distracted by your struggles. He's not distracted on the outward things, amen, that are going on in your life. He's not distracted even by who you are or what you're struggling with right now. He's not distracted by your issues, amen, because he knows and he put something in you before the foundations of the world, amen. And he knows, amen, that regardless of what you're doing, regardless of how you're living, regardless of what you may be dealing with, amen, that he has something valuable in you, amen. Somebody say, there's a treasure in me, amen. God is not like us. He doesn't choose things, amen, because of the outward package. Amen. A lot of times we choose things because the package appeals to us and we end up messed up because of it. Amen. We choose food because it looks good on the package. Amen. We choose mate because they look good in the package. Amen. We'll buy the wrong size shoes because they look good and mess our feet up. Amen. Because we get preoccupied with what we see on the outside. But a lot of times, amen, we don't recognize that what we see on the outside is often a misrepresentation of what is on the inside. Amen. And oftentimes, because of our environment, what we're surrounded with, oftentimes because of who we look like and where we are geographically or where we are in our lives, amen, we don't recognize our value, amen, in God. Amen. We don't recognize that where I am geographically, what I'm struggling with, amen, what I'm dealing with, what family I came from has nothing to do with what God has put down on the inside of me. And we allow our experiences oftentimes to confuse us about our value in God because we think that because we go through hard times, because we face difficulty, because, amen, oftentimes we've been rejected by man, amen, we don't value ourselves or realize our self-worth, and so we end up a lot of times living beneath our privilege. Somebody shout, there's a treasure in me. And so you have to understand that because God has put something on the inside of you, oftentimes God will take you through a process where he breaks down the outer package, amen, in order to unveil or to get to the treasure, amen. I shared with you on last week the illustration of how sometimes, amen, when you have a jar or something or a package of something, the way that you get into that thing, amen, especially if it's a difficult thing, amen, you know, sometimes you got to, you know, tap it with something. You got to hit it with something. You got to pop the bottom of it. You got to run hot water on it. But if one thing doesn't work to allow you, amen, to get to the treasure that you're seeking, you will try something else. So there are some of us, amen, that God has to take through many different processes in order to get to the treasure that's on the inside of us, amen. Can I help somebody? The stronger you are, the harder the process, amen. The harder your head, the harder the process, amen. So sometimes we go through some things and we think because of what we chapter, the 7th and 6th verse, it says, "For God commanded the light to shine out of darkness, and he has shined in our hearts." Amen. You have to understand that sometimes life and how you see yourself, amen, can cause you to live in a state of darkness. Amen. It will cause you to give in to the powers of darkness. Amen. But I have to tell somebody, I don't care how far you've gone. Amen. How low you've gone. It doesn't matter to God, because God has a way of dealing with darkness. Amen. I don't care if you darken your mind, darken your heart. If you live because we all know